大家好，我是田老师。Today we will learn lesson 13, asking directions. 问路，问路。Okay, let's learn the vocabulary first. First one is 上。上, we learned this before, means going up or above. But right now, it's a verb, means to go. How to use it?
上学。Go to school, 上学。你上哪儿去？
Where are you going? 你上哪儿去？ It equals to, 你去哪儿？
你上哪儿去？
我上学去。
你去哪儿？
我去上学。Next one, 中心。中心 means center. This means if I have circle, that's here, center.
电脑中心。
电脑中心 means computer center. 电 means electricity. 脑 means head or brain.
电脑中心 computer center.
Next one, 听说。听 means listen.
说 means speak.
Listen to others speaking means to be told or heard of.
听说。
For example,
我听说你是美国人。
I heard that you are American.
我听说。
Next one is 运动。
运动
means sports or exercise.
我喜欢运动。
I like to do exercise.
我喜欢运动。
Next one, field, 场。
场
means field.
运动场
sports, field,
运动场。
Next one, 旁边。
旁边
means side.How to use it? Somewhere,
在
somewhere,
旁边
a location here, another location here, use 在 and 旁边 connect all of these two locations. For example,
电脑中心
在
运动场
旁边
电脑中心
在 means at or be located at.
电脑中心在运动场旁边。
电脑中心 is next to the sports field.
电脑中心在运动场旁边。
Okay, next one is 远。
远
means far. This radical means 走之 is simplified 走 walk. Walk a long distance means far.
远
means far. Next one,
离。
离 means away from.
离。
Next one,
近。
近 means near. For example,
电脑中心
离
图书馆很近。
电脑中心 is very close to
图书馆。
Somewhere
离
another location 很近。Somewhere is very close to somewhere.
电脑中心离图书馆很近。
运动场。
运动场
离图书馆很近。They are very close. Next one,
活动。
活动 means activity.
活动。
Next one, 中间。
中间
means middle.
中 means middle
or center. 间 means room. So 中间 is not like 中心，中心 is the center. And 中间 means if I have three rooms, the middle one is 中间。间 means has the meaning of room. 洗手间，洗手间，洗 means wash. 手 means hand. 洗手 wash my hand. Room, that's the restroom. 洗手间。Next one, 书店，书店，书 means book, 店 means store, bookstore, 书店。How about the restaurant? It's 饭店，饭店，food store or meal store. That's a restaurant. Next one, 地方，地方 means place. Remember, this one is neutral tone, so make it short. 地方，地方。For example, 书店在什么地方？书店在什么地方？ Where is the bookstore? 书店 at what place? 书店在什么地方？ Next one, 里边，里边， this 边 still the neutral tone. 里边 means inside.Let's learn some grammar about the direction and location words. First one, if we have a car like this, and the car is driving to this direction, this one is front, is 前, 前. This one is the back, it's 后, 后. How about the top? 上.Under or the bottom of the car is 下, and how to describe this? It's 上边 or 上面 or 上头. You have three options, so just choose one. Maybe the one you feel very good, so just choose one from these to describe the location. 边面头, when these three combine with the direction word, it became the toneless. 边面头, if combined with these direction words, 上后下前 and some others, we cannot have the tone with them. We take them away. For example, 前边前面前头前边前面前头 Okay, how about inside the car?里边，里面，里头。How about outside the car? 外边，外面，外头。Let's make examples or make some sentences. 我在，我在车里边。I'm inside the car. 我在 means at or be located at. I am in the car. 我在车里面。我在车前面。我在车后边。
Okay. Use 在 and then plus the direction word. Okay, next one. Let's learn the left, middle, and the right. The middle one is 中间中间 the girl is in the middle. 女孩在中间女孩在中间 We still use 在 because we are talking about the direction or the location. this boy or 他 he 在左边 means left. 他在左边And 他在右边他在右边right side. Sometimes you can also say left hand side. Put a 手 hand between 左 and 边左手边Left hand side, 左手边，右手边 right hand side, 右手边。他在中间，他在左手边，他在右手边。Okay, let's learn north, east, south, and west here.This one is north, 北, 北, this is 南, 东 is east, 西. Let's make some examples. We don't only use 北 to say that's the north. We need to add 面.而边北京在北边北京在北边南海南在南面海南在南面 We only add 边 or 面 Don't add 头 Here That's wrong Only plus 边 or 面东 Which city 在东边上海在东边在东边Which city 在西边？西安在西边。So, 北京在北边，海南在南面，上海在东边，西安在。西边 you can memorize only with these four words or four characters. 东南西北东 is very short to memorize. 东南西北 East, South, West, and North.东南西北东南西北 So, read these four characters more times and it will be memorized in your mind. East, South, West, North. 东南西北东南西北 Okay, let's move on to next one is the noun plus 上 and 里 how to translate this? We translate it like 上 plus noun
上on something, inside something. Let's see the examples. 桌子上有两个苹果。On the table has two apples. So when you interpret this, go this way. On something, inside something. 桌子上 on the table has 两个苹果 apples. 运动场上 the sports field, noun plus 上 has 很多人，运动场上有很多人 too many people. Next one, 车里 inside the car, inside the car, 有三个小男孩。Inside the car has three little boys. There are three little boys in the car. On our textbook, you will see 北京里有很多学生. We don't use it like this way because 里 means inside. That means the noun we are talking about is like a container or a room.So, Beijing is a city, it's not a room or a container, the shape like a container. So, we cannot use 里. We just say, 北京有很多学生. We don't say, 北京里有很多学生. Okay. The comparative sentence with 没有.The comparative sentence we learned before is 比 how to use it? Something 比 something plus adjective. If for example, 我比你高，我比你高，compare.I compare with you is taller, means I'm taller than you. I'm taller than you. How about 没有? We know 没 is a negative word. So 没有 means A is not something, not adjective as B. For example,我妈妈 my mom 没有我高 is not as tall as me. How to convert it into this one? Equals to switch the position 我 and 我妈妈我比我妈妈高I'm taller than my mom. My mom is not as tall as me. Another example, 北京没上海热。北京 is not that hot as 上海。Let's convert it into 比. Switch the position, 上海 and 北京。上海比sorry, 北京热。上海 is hotter than 北京。北京 is not as hot as 上海。北京没上海热 equals to 上海比北京热。How to differentiate 比不比 and 没有 Let's see.Do some example. A 比 B 大 We use 大 to replace the adjective. Here, A is bigger than B. A is bigger than B. We use this sign. A 不比 B 大 That means the opposite of the first one. A is not as big as B. Use this sign. A 没有 B 大 A is less than B. So this one has the chance that A equals B. For example, 今天比昨天热。Today, compared with yesterday, is hot. A is hotter than B. 今天比昨天热。今天不比昨天热。A compare with, oh, sorry. 今天 compare with 昨天 is not that, as cold. It's not as cold as 昨天。A 没有 B, 热。今天没有昨天热。Means today is not as hot as yesterday. So the relationship between A and 昨天 and 今天 A 比昨天热 So A is hotter than yesterday. 今天不比昨天热不比 That means it's not as hot as yesterday.今天没有昨天热 That means 昨天 is hotter than 今天 So memorize the relationship with A and B If they have with 比不比 and 没有 OK, next one 那么 indicates the degree of the adjective. For example, if I have an adjective like 高, tall, or high, I have 那么高 那么高 is a higher degree. I can use this sign. 那么高 is higher, indicates the higher.Degree of this adjective. 那么 is normally is used in the negative sentence or the question. For example, 电脑中心没有运动场那么远 Computer center is not as that far as.The sports field. How to convert it into be equals to switch the position A and B. 运动场比电脑中心Why I don't have 那么 here? Because this is just a statement. I don't have a negative word or the question, 么 question maker, 么 So we only have 远 adjective here without 那么 because this is a statement. Next example, 弟弟没有哥哥那么帅the younger brother is not as that handsome as his brother, the older brother. so, how to convert it with be sentence? So, if we convert it into the be sentence, comparative sentence, we cannot keep the 那么. So, get rid of the 那么 and switch the position 哥哥And 弟弟，哥哥
比弟弟帅帅 means handsome
哥哥比弟弟帅 equals to 弟弟没有哥哥那么帅 So it's confusing but you practice more you will get this point
帅 means handsome how to say the handsome guy 帅哥
Is handsome guy,
帅哥
Okay, next one. 到 plus a place plus 去 plus an action. 到 means go to somewhere to do something means go to somewhere to do something. 去 somewhere. 到 somewhere 去做什么？
Okay, for example, 我要到电脑中心去上网。我要到电脑中心去上网。
I want to go to the computer center to use the internet.
我要到电脑中心去上网。
Next example.
我到 somewhere 朋友家去聊天了。
I went to my friend's house
去
to chat. La means this action is completed. So we have a la here. Mm-hmm. We can interpret that's the past tense.
Next one, 我们到飞机场送李小姐了。
我们 we 到 go to the airport, 飞机场 delivery, this is a verb, is action, 送李小姐了。Delivery Miss Lee and the past tense maker or completion maker.Go to somewhere to do something.